Let's speak now to Jane Townson from the Homecare Association, which is behind this report, which has been published today. Jane, what are your suggestions for how to tackle this problem?
Oh, good morning. Well, there are both long-term and short-term measures that could be taken. Long-term, we need social care funded adequately so that home care workers can be paid fairly for the skilled roles they perform. We need, the funding is also tied up with how home care is commissioned and purchased by public bodies. And because they have had their budget squeezed over the last decade, they've had to ration care, and many of them purchase home care by the minute, which means that care workers end up being paid by the minute. And there aren't any other branches of society where that happens. So that's another factor that needs to be addressed. And then long term, we need an expert-led workforce strategy, a 10-year plan to go alongside the NHS people plan. And ultimately, if we can get sufficient funding, sufficient training to ensure that the workforce is fully skilled and competent for all of the different types of tasks and roles they have to perform. We'd like to see a professional register in England. There's already a professional register for care workers in Northern Ireland, Scotland and Wales. And that's a really good basis on which to support the longer term development of the workforce.
What is the, for people who don't know, what's the average wage of someone working in the care sector? And realistically, what should that be set at to try and address some of these long-term problems?
Well, many of them, unfortunately, are still paid pretty close to the national minimum wage. I think the average is a bit above that. But we're finding substantial competition from other business sectors. That's always been the case, but it's become more intense recently. So we hear stories of large companies offering £1,000 starting bonuses and £13.50 an hour. And we're, struggling trying to even get close to the real living wage at £9.50 an hour, which we still don't think is enough. We think we probably need to be in the £12, £13 an hour mark. And that would be equivalent to a band 3 healthcare assistant in the NHS. And we feel that there should be parity with the NHS because the skills and experience and the kind of tasks they're required to perform are very similar.
And as basically as Stephen was saying, they're so valued by the people receiving that care as well. Jane, it's really good to speak to you. Thanks so much.